gosh, the camera put 50 pounds on me.
Lead.
This mohawk ain't working out on TV.
Hey.
We're both starting the show today.
We've got heat stroke.
We do have heat stroke. Today's show's on
Heat stroke.
Mm-hmm. I've had a stroke, all right, but I don't know if it was heat related. Gosh. Well, welcome. It's August 9th, Friday.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Welcome
day.
To the
Happy
show.
Happy Friday. Mm-hmm. Looking forward to the weekend.
Yeah. And CNA Fest is almost here.
Oh, gosh. Don't give me a heart attack.
Well.
That gives me a stroke.
That may be a different show.
We got to make sure we don't have any heat strokes at the end of August. This mm-hmm. the end of this month in 20 days, 19 and 20 days. Mm-hmm. 200 or so of us will be outside at CNA Fest. Mm-hmm. And tell us what we need to watch out for, Corinne.
Yeah. So the signs and symptoms is extremely high body temperature above 103. You're
all right.
red, hot, dry skin. You're not sweating. You're going to have that rapid pulse and also a very strong pulse.
Hard and fast.
Hard and fast. You're going to know something's going on.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
That throbbing headache that will not go away with anything. You're also going to have dizziness and nausea. So if you have any of these symptoms and you're at CNA Fest, please reach out to that CNA that's sitting next to you.
Throbbing headache. I'm working. I'm acting out the symptoms mm-hmm. so they'll know.
Yeah.
Dizziness.
Mm-hmm. Because actually these symptoms and the chance of having heat stroke, it could cause death or permanent disability. So emergency treatment is, it needs to be provided right away. Also keep track of all those precious elders that you are taking care of. Yeah.
We should really do some scientific study so we can give out some statistics mm-hmm. sometimes with these shows, but yeah. It happens so much quicker in our residents when they're outside simply because they just don't have the intake really that's necessary to withstand high heat. So, yeah.
And also make sure that when you give someone water or something cool to drink, make sure that it is actually kind of like at room temperature. If you give someone that's an ice cold drink of iced tea or soda or anything, it can actually cause more damage than good when I was doing some research on this. Because
my
it cools your body down
says
too,
drink
much,
water, too much. Water at room temperature.
Yeah, especially when you're outside. So, you know, take care of yourself. Take care of your residents. Also, like Lori said, you know, CNA Fest is right here. It's knocking at our door. So also make sure that you come prepared for that. Bring your suntan, lotion, your screen, wear a hat. You know, just make sure that you have all those items with you because they may not be available at the facility
There'll always
that we're going to be at.
There will be plenty of fluids available. Yes. Mm-hmm. Don't worry about bring and drink. Plenty of fluid available. We may have some sunscreen and some things like that available. Obviously we will and have a first aid kit, but we all need to be aware that it doesn't take more. Most all of us think we're immune to it until somebody has a heat stroke and then we realize what the damage can really be. So
that's true. So take care of yourself and come back and see us. We have two more topics to talk to you about. And then we'll have this series wrapped up. So come back and join us on the Chill Spot again. A
couple more episodes on the heat. And then we're moving on.
We're out of here.
We have to really push this heat because I've read some stories recently of residents who had died by being left outside and forgotten in the heat. And this happens more and more. I actually reviewed over 30 cases this year of heat-related deaths in elders in long-term care. So we can't be too vigilant about keeping an eye out.
So make sure you take care of them and come back and join us again on the Chill Spot. And remember, you matter.